We Awoken were born of light and dark. Our perspective on the universe is a complex one. The light is not inherently good, as your warlords of the Dark Age so clearly demonstrated. In spite of Zavala's preconceptions, darkness is not inherently evil. Some among you already discovered this on Europa. In my travels, I have seen true evil. It is the worm gods that the Hive serve. It is the Black Fleet, waiting to strike. It is the entity that commands them all. The voice in the darkness. These creatures are not evil because they wield darkness. They are evil because, like Sarathun and Zeal Araf, they are cruel, hateful things with no regard for the lives of others. Some might say that includes me as well. I will let history be the judge of my guilt. Before that judgment is cast, I will see my Tekians returned. Perhaps with them, I can save us all.
Attacks against the Blind Well have become stronger lately.
Is Zeevu Arath trying to rescue Sabathun?
Zeevu Arath has plans for her sister. They do not involve a rescue.
We've got to prevent the Scorn from poisoning the ley lines. Destroy the ether before they can harvest it.
Are we sure there's no way to save that ether? I know a lot of Elixni on the shore who could really use it.
This is no time for sympathy. We're here to save the Dreaming City, not the Elixni.
It pains me to say it, but we need to target the ether coming from the Servitors. It's better off destroyed than in the hands of the Scorn. but anything to get the Scorn out of the area.
War is always a waste of good resources. Get used to it. We need to replace the batteries for the Blindwell's regulators. They're dense with paracausal energy, so it'll take teamwork to get them installed.
Shouldn't be too difficult. How heavy could they be?
The ley lines must be stabilized. Install the batteries to end this invasion.
Carrying those batteries felt empowering.
The radiation they emit is largely unstudied. I wouldn't hold them for too long.
Make sure you keep your compass safe. Things are about to get loud.
also be working with other Awoken.
Petra and Mara certainly are different than Zavala. They're a touch... prickly.
Can't argue with that. I just wondered if you feel more comfortable around your people.
Yeah, it's a little hard to identify with magic people who arose from a paracausal black hole.
You've all lived through different hardships, but you might have more in common than you think.
Align the beacons, Guardian, and signal the way home.
Beacon ahead. Be cautious.
Peace.
Now we know what Zebu Arad was planning for her Wrathborn armies. She intends to conquer the Ascendant Plane.
Thank you. Down. Guardian down. Guardian down. Guardian down. Thank you.
forces are in retreat. Let's bring our lost sister home.
This is a world divided. With the Techians, we can begin to stabilize it. I am presenting you with this responsibility, Guardian.
To my knowledge, the downfall of the Dreaming City is not the doing of Guardians.
Guardians found a cracked pane of glass and decided to crash through it. Now that I've returned to the scattered pieces, you feign ignorance to how they got there.
I am not feigning ignorance. I am ignorant. I was dead for a very long time, you see.
Yes. Osiris spoke of you frequently during our visits.
Then you understand that if he does not return, you answer to me.
Fear not, Saint. Everything is as it should be. Do your part, and I will do mine.
Osiris was like family to me.
You've never even met him.
I know. Just let me speak to Sabathun, please.
No. I won't give that witch another chance to dig her claws into you.
Maybe she's right, Crone.
You know I am. Sabathun is already in your head. You're a liability to the mission.
Why do you have such a problem with me, Petra? 5 minutes, that's all I'm asking.
The Queen of the Reef forbids it.
Well, I don't take commands from the Queen of the Reef.
Sabathun unraveled the Dreaming City with a single wish. I've spent years trying to contain that mistake. Better men than you died because of it.
To my ear, it sounds like you're the liability. Maybe your Queen's trust in you was misplaced. A knife against a hunter? I'd be more careful who you pick fights with.
Another step, and my corsairs will have to prepare you a second grave.
Save it for the Hive, both of you. This isn't getting us anywhere. Thank you. We could all probably use a minute to cool off. Oh
no.
Keep both eyes on that one.
You can't stop the inevitable. No one can, though Petra Vang seems perfectly willing to try. I've always sympathized with Crow, you know. All the kind words I shared with him as Osiris were sincere. I know what it's like to be an exile. To be hated for things outside of your control. It would be better for Crow if we talked. I want to explain why I did what I did. I want him to know that my affection is true, because the less he knows, the more vulnerable he is. Doomed to be strung along by false promises from supposed benefactors. But then again, I'm the one trapped in the crystal prison. What do I know?
Venge thinks I'm vulnerable, and I'm supposed to just take a seat? Like I was the only one fooled by Savathun wearing Osiris's skin? You'd known him far longer than I thought I had, but I don't see her forbidding you from speaking to her. Because it's not about me. It's about who I was, isn't it? Every time the Vanguard tells me that things will get better, I thank them. As if it's a privilege not to be beaten to death. Our past lives aren't supposed to matter. I'm beginning to wonder why I'm the only guardian being judged by mine. No more apologies. No more creeping around on eggshells. I deserve an audience with Savathun. I deserve to know how much of what she told me as Osiris was a lie. I deserve answers.
I don't need to be Marisov to see into your mind, Guardian. You think I'm making a mistake? You think I barred Crow out of pettiness? I won't say I didn't recommend it, but it was the Queen's order, for his own safety. I see Prince Aldrin's arrogance in him, his desire to please. He's vulnerable. Aldrin and your Crow are echoes of each other. Surely you can see that. They share kindred weaknesses. Savathun will exploit them again if we let her. But with Mara back, I can finally see the end approaching. It's been a long time coming. There are still Tekians in need of your strength. I wish I could fill their place, but this must be how things are. I'm here if you need me.
Recently, the Vanguard has been scrutinized for a lack of transparency, and we've paid for it. I hope this broadcast represents our efforts to the contrary. Many of you came to me having witnessed the Vex attack. Many of you claim to have seen Osiris present there. We now know this was a deception, an illusion spread by our enemies to turn us against each other. It worked for a time. Mourn those lost to the senseless violence unleashed in our streets. But we have overcome that fear, and we now stand united. Humanity, Elixni, and the Awoken of the Reef. Our allegiance is what the Witch Queen fears. It is what she meant to stop by sowing discord. It is what will lead us to victory. Know that this battle is not one we are bringing to your doorstep, but it is one we fight to keep the city out of the line of fire. The Vanguard asks for your patience and understanding. If you can offer those, we will offer what insights we can to your questions. You are always welcome in the tower, but I